Okay. So, I got a lot of comments, people writing in, telling me different ideas for videos, and I thought the best one to start with would be Terrence Crutcher and the acquittal of his murderer, Betty Jo Shelby. And I just, here's the thing that gets me about this, right? Like, you look at her picture. Her name's Betty Jo, you know? And she just has, like, this smile, like, just all-American name. And you just think, well, there couldn't be a mean bone in her body, right? And there's so much hideous ugliness inside of this woman. And then she looked at this man, and she thought, oh, there's something, he's gonna have a gun, or he's, there's something wrong with him, you know, that he needs shot. You know, he's scary, he's big and scary. I think that was her defense, was he was big and scary. Well, there's a lot of tall men out there. And my son, you know, his dad's 6'6", so he's probably gonna grow up to be a big guy. And I think it's terrifying to think that, you know, he could be pulled over one day and a cop just shoot him because he looks scary. But, you know, Terrence was doing everything right by society standards. You know, he had the family, he had 4 kids, he's singing in the choir, going to school. And what happens? His car breaks down and he gets murdered by the people that are supposed to be there to protect him. And I guarantee you, if that man would have been white, the cops would have stopped. And they would have said, how can we help you? Oh, we'll get roadside assistance out to you or something. They would not have shot him. I mean, you could hear her husband up in the helicopter, and he's talking about, you know, I'll tase that thing. He said, you know, he looks like a bad dude, looks like he's on something. How could he tell? He's up in the helicopter. And that speaks to her character, because she looked at that man and said, hey, I want to marry him. You know, like that, she was okay with that. And still married him, even though he has thoughts like that. You know, it's gross. It's sick. And you know, then you have Bill Maher that comes on, and he wants to use this to get us to vote for Hillary. You think Hillary would have been any better? You know, going around talking about bring them to heel, super predators, walking up black people. And then they're gonna say, like, oh, well, where are the fathers? Well, you know, maybe the police should stop killing the fathers, you know? It's messed up. And then you got, the whole thing's corrupt. The whole system is corrupt. And I think a big factor of that is the union, the police union. They stick together. Now, I've always advocated for unions, but there is a dark side to unions, which is it protects the people that's in them and not so much the people that aren't. And if you're not a police officer, there's nothing really you can do about that, right? So, I mean, we need to reform the police. We need to have this based in the communities. The communities need to, you know, be in charge of the police, point blank. Like, that's the only solution to this, because you're not going to get, if it's community policing their own community, you're not going to get people that's going to be shooting their neighbors, you know. Well, maybe some people, but I mean, you're not going to get that. Not unless they absolutely have to, because it's not going to be somebody, some stranger, it's going to be somebody that they know. And We need to do some work. And Bill Maher saying that Hillary would have come in and, like, made things better. You know she wouldn't have. Obama, a black man, did not do it. You think Hillary's gonna do it? That's insane. I can't stand it. I can't stand it, because, I mean, and here's what says everything about, I think, police culture is, you know, the fact that, you know, here in West Virginia, we had a woman that called the police before, because her brother was suicidal, and the police showed up, you know, there was a cop that showed up, and, you know, he tried to defuse the situation. And, you know, this guy was trying to do suicide by cop, so he tried talking about it. He kept saying, I'm not going to shoot you, brother. I'm not going to do it. And his backup showed up, shot, killed the guy, and then gets him fired for not killing him. He was fired for not killing somebody, for not killing a suicidal man. And, you know, that's the thing. And you don't think that that's not in the back of their heads? Every time that happens now, especially here, they're going to think, do I want to be fired? It's me or him, right? So if I want to keep my job, I'm going to have to kill this guy. You know, that's what they're showing with this. Instead of having a little bit of restraint and trying to talk the guy down, no, I mean, you better have your finger on that trigger or else you're going to be fired. And this has to end. And I think that white people need to recognize that this isn't a black problem. And I hate to say that, and I know a lot of white people do, but you know, they see it as like, that's a black problem, and it's not. I mean, white people get shot a whole hell of a lot too. Just based on, you know, population, it happens more to black people. And we need to come together and get the solutions for this. But that goes to every problem, you know. Here in America, you know, you think that, you know, it's somebody else, it's always somebody else's problem. Well, we're all in the same boat. And if there's a hole in the boat on the other end, you better believe it's going to affect us. So we need to start doing our part and advocating for, you know, police reform. I mean, it's just all there is to it. And it's not going to be the politicians that fix this. It's going to have to be the community, and it's going to have to be us. And we're going to have to put the pressure on them to make these changes. But that's all I got to say on that. Mostly.